Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Matt with Art of Matlock. I'm here today. Today I'm going to go over some basics. Today's figure portrait will be Bob Marley, just in commemoration of his birthday. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to go over some supplies that we're going to use for today's tutorial. So let's start. We're going to use the Staedtler Mars Plastic Eraser. This is good for covering a nice general distance, more of a broad distance. If you have to erase any mistakes, or it's also good for blending. Next up, the next eraser we will be using is I believe this is the Tough Stuff Paper Mate Eraser Stick. This works great for honing in on detail, getting close to edges, erasing tight, close lines. Mechanical pencil. I use this a majority of the time to actually build in the general shapes for the character. Also the plane that a lot of times the eyes sit on, or the face itself. And then let's move on to, these are some old pencils I had sitting around. This is Pro Art. This is a B, and this is the Pro Art 2B. This is going to help build some of the values, a lot of the darker values that we have in our portrait today. So let's go ahead and let's get started. So let's put all this to the side here. Start with my mechanical pencil. So I have a nice little reference photo just for today's tutorial, and I'm going to show you how I basically start off. So we're going to start here with a circle, just to kind of give you an idea. So we have the general circle here. The face is pretty much sitting on like a three-quarter view. So the three-quarter view, we'll draw a line about almost halfway through, but not really, more towards the left side of the face. And this is where the nose is going to sit. The nose kind of sits on a plane here on a slant. There. And then the jawline builds off of this here. So it falls somewhere in this area, and we'll build into that shape. You'll see that progress, and that'll actually, you know, start to define itself once we start building in more of the facial structure. So next, I like to kind of sketch in kind of where the eye sockets would fall. And then from there, we'll build in our eyes. So I kind of almost do, everything starts with like a circle or a cylinder. You can build off of that and kind of build into your own little polygonal, you know, polygonal shape to kind of, you know, define your own style. I like to just play with different shapes just to, you know, stand apart from the crowd a little bit. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to work on what would be his right side socket. And we'll start sketching the nose in, just kind of building that in. You'll see, you know, throughout the tutorial how that'll actually start to define as well. So I'm pretty excited, guys. I had pretty good past couple of days. Had my first solo live art show in New Brunswick, New Jersey. I'm actually booking shows as we speak. Next one may be in New York, which would be cool. I'm excited. If it happens, it happens. If it doesn't, it doesn't. But you know, it's always good just to have those talks and, you know, just kind of like, you know, have something to look forward to. So here we are, building in where the eyes would sit. We have our nose. The mouth kind of sits down here because he's got a little stash, so we got to leave a little bit of space for his mustache. So we'll kind of sketch that in. I like to just lightly sketch that in and then build the shape from there. And we'll start adding in his lips. And then after this tutorial, if you guys have any questions, I'm pretty much always available. I try and get to you guys as soon as possible. But just let me know. All my contact information is on my site. My website is www.artofmatlock.com. Okay, so now we're going to start building into the cheekbone. Build that shape in. Now what you see here is a lot of times in the eye socket area, that'll kind of cave in a little bit. We'll give a little bit away there. So you guys, he has high cheekbones, very defined. So what you do is you note, you know, right in your reference photo where things pretty much lie in correlation to everything else. What you pay attention to the facial structure, that is extremely important upon building, because that's how you'll get like a true likeness. And then when people look at it, say, hey, you know what, that, wow, that does look exactly like Bob Marley. So continue building this in, kind of get the shape of his head here. Building some hair. His hair is kind of longer than he's had a hat on in this photo, so just kind of generally build that shape in, and we'll build on that. What I like to do is use a lot of, you know, our like I said earlier, the B and the 2B to kind of build in the details of the hair. Got some hair on this side as well, kind of coming out of his hat. Some eyebrows here. What I like to do, especially when using a reference photo, just take note of the angles. A nice little tip that I've picked up over the years, if you are drawing, like especially if you have like a figure in front of you, pay attention. You a lot of times take the angle of the pencil, hold up to your photo just to kind of get, okay, well, the eyes sit on this plane here, boom. So that will get, that will basically give you a true angle to where that angle of those eyes or the features actually lie. So same thing with the nose, kind of sits on the plane there like that. And what you'll do is you'll take it, you'll hold up to your photo, and then take that same angle and kind of place it down onto your drawing to get that same, you know, same angle to actually, you know, get the right proportions. Pardon that YouTube commercial playing in the background. A lot of times when I like to draw, I like to play some music, kind of just get the mood going. This is part of his ear here, so we'll kind of just sketch this in lightly. We'll build on that later. That's sketched in, that's in. Jawbone here. Got a piece of that there. Stash builds up into here, so stash goes down into here. A little bit of hair there. This builds up into here, and this will come back here, so that'll be back there. This is part of his neck, so we'll build this in here. It's a little bit of hair building off his back ear, comes down, kind of a little curly thing there. So that's that. And then that hat will kind of build off of here and come out here. Right. So now start creating the eyes. See, and the thing I like about the actual mechanical pencils, allows you to get real tight on detail. Allows you to really pronounce, you know, sharpen your actual corners and the edges of your drawing, which is awesome. See, and this is a good thing about this. Like, if you notice that your proportions may be off slightly, it's so easy just to erase. Like, I may move this over. I might just erase this whole thing just to show you guys. Just, hey, look, it's okay to make a mistake. And we'll just build this in. So we're gonna go in here. So with that generally sketched in, start building in more of the nose. The hardest edge, the darkest edge is on the left side. So while you're sketching and you're drawing, notice the darkest points of the face. A lot of times you can add those in first and then build your values from there. What I would do though is if you're going to do that in that order, I would start to just build those in lightly, because then your darkest points, as you'll see, when you step away from your drawing, you may want to add them darker. You want to have them lighter like how they are, but you'll definitely notice throughout the drawing as you're actually progressing.
We lift our hands and give our praise.
So here I am still sketching this in very lightly. So I'm going to build on these values throughout the progression of this. So here I am just paying attention to the shading of the face, paying attention to the light source as well. It's a good thing to do. Once you start realizing where exactly light is coming from, how many light sources you have, then you can actually apply that to your own characters. So that's why I like to do a lot of studies. The studies then help me, especially when I'm doing like my own characters. I do some comic book sketching or, you know, just my own little just random sketching just throughout my days. And I like to use a lot of like the same light sources just in my characters or my little short comics, things like that. So here I'm going to take my eraser. This is part of that foundation that we laid down, that actual circle. So we're going to start erasing some of those lines as well. Try to keep the drawing as smooth as possible. So that's that.
Monday.